Dear students, now we will see, last class we saw how to bias depletion MOSFET. In this class we will see biasing enhancement MOSFET. So e-MOSFET, there are two configuration here. One is called as a feedback, one is feedback configuration, feedback biasing. Second one is a voltage divider configuration, just like what we saw in the last class. First one is a feedback biasing. So here feedback biasing, circuit diagram for the feedback biasing. So you can see here, this is the voltage VDD, drain voltage VDD and ID current, and this is my enhancement MOSFET. Here drain resistance is there. In addition to the drain resistance, I have connected a feedback resistor RG through which bias voltage moves to the gate. So resistor RG provides a feedback connection which provides bias voltage to turn on. So this is the meaning of feedback biasing. So we need to find out here ID and VDS and VGS. So now here we will, in this case we will apply to find graphical method, that is called as a DC load line method or graphical method, to find out the Q point, to find out the Q point. Now what is this graphical method? We will see. For that we first need to write Kirchhoff voltage law for input loop. So now this is the input loop. So now what is Kirchhoff voltage law? I told in the previous class what is Kirchhoff voltage law. So we will write directly here Kirchhoff voltage law, VDD minus IDRD and minus IG, that is the gate current, RG minus VGS is equal to 0. Now MOSFET, we know because of the insulation between gate and substrate, there is a minimum gate current, that in terms of picoamps, that's why IG is 0. So when you substitute IG is equal to 0 in the above equation, you will get the equation VDD minus ID, VDD minus ID RD and minus VGS is equal to 0. Now you can see here, my dear students, it has got ID and VGS. A equation contains ID and VGS. In our last lecture we studied that is transfer characteristics. What is transfer characteristics? Transfer characteristics is nothing but ID versus VGS, that is input versus output, that is called as a transfer characteristics. So here it contains the transfer characteristics. Other than that, this equation is called as a DC equation. This equation is called as a DC load line equation. So now what we are going to do is we will draw the transfer characteristics, and we, by using this equation, we will superimpose one more curve on this transfer characteristics, and the point where the both equation satisfies is called as a quotient point or bias point. So you see here, so this equation is reduced to VDD minus ID RD VGS is equal to 0, or VGS is equal to VDD minus ID RD. Now in this case, Suppose if I take VGS is equal to 0, put VGS is equal to 0, that time I will get VDD is equal to IDRD or ID is equal to VDD by RD. Now I will put in the same equation, I will put ID is equal to 0, then that time VGS is equal to VDD. VGS is equal to VDD, that means we got 2 points. That is, in the above equation, when I take VGS is 0, I will get 1 point. In the above equation, when I take VGS is equal to 0, I will get 1 point. When I take ID is equal to 0, I will get one more point. So initially we have to draw transfer characteristics. This is the transfer characteristics here. You can know this is the transfer characteristics. That is ID versus VGS. And by using DC load line method or DC equation, I will get 2 points. I will join that one. And the point where this both equation satisfies is called as Q point or operating point. And this is the method this is called graphical method determining operating point by using DC load line method. This one is known as graphical method for drawing operating point by using this DC load line method. So next students, once again we will try to solve the problem in the above case. So you can see here, we have the enhancement MOSFET. We have enhancement MOSFET. We have enhancement MOSFET here. You can see enhancement MOSFET is there. How will you come to know whether it is enhancement MOSFET? By seeing, because of this dotted line. That means drain and source are not electrically connected. There is no channel between drain and source. Unless and until you give VGS, channel won't be established. So this is the depletion, enhancement MOSFET. So and it is N-channel enhancement MOSFET. This is N-channel enhancement MOSFET. You will come to know because the arrow mark is towards inside. This is N-channel enhancement MOSFET. And you have drain resistance, you have feedback resistance RG, and IG, VDS, all these terms we know. And RD is given 1 kilo ohm. RD is given 1 kilo ohm. And here, one more parameter is given. For E MOSFET, threshold voltage is 2 volt. Threshold voltage is 2 volt. What do you mean by threshold voltage is 2 volt? So, enhancement MOSFET, threshold voltage is 2 volt. This is because, here, in the enhancement MOSFET, there is no channel between drain to source. Unless and until you give VGS, channel won't be established. So what value, what is the value of VGS you have to give so that channel will be established and current will flow between drain to source? That value is called as, that value should be greater than some fixed value, greater than a particular value, and that is called as threshold value. So the meaning of threshold voltage is if I give VGS more than 2 volt, their channel will be built between drain to source, then later current will flow when you increase VDS between drain to source. That is called as a threshold voltage. Threshold voltage is given 2 volt. And ID 1, see it is given here, ID is not given. ID 1 for VGS 1, for some value of VGS 1, ID 1 is equal to 6 milliamperes. So now, drain current we have to find out and we have to find out VDS. So now drain current for enhancement MOSFET, this equation we have to use ID K into VGS minus VT. K is called as transconductance. So please make a note, K is called as transconductance. It depends on process conductance value. So we will not go in deep into it. We have to find out K. So substitute the value for ID and VGS and VT, you will get K is equal to 0.67 milliamps. Now, gate source voltage in the feedback configuration is given by this. So now we have to find out. So we got K. Now we have to find out VDS and ID. For that, we will apply Kirchhoff's law in the input loop. So when you apply the Kirchhoff's laws in the input loop, so this is the input loop. So when you apply the Kirchhoff's laws in the input loop, then we can write VDD minus VDD minus then IDRD minus IGRG minus VGS is equal to 0. This is the Kirchhoff law, right? For the input loop. So applying the Kirchhoff law for the input loop, in the above equation, because IG is very low, so we have to make IG is equal to 0. Then IG is equal to 0, this component, this term, this component becomes 0, this component becomes 0. Then our Kirchhoff law will be reduced to this one. Kirchhoff law will be reduced to this one, and you can rewrite this one, and we will use this one to find out VGS. VDD we know, minus ID and RD. Now what is RD in our case? In our case, RD is given. So our VGS is 15 minus 1000 ID. 15 minus 1000 ID, that equation we have to use. Now, here ID is equal to ID is equal to K VGS minus VT. We have one more equation. So we know the value of K. So substituting this ID in the above here in this equation, substituting the value of K, we got one more equation, ID, this one. And so we will take this equation, dear friends, don't confuse. We will take this equation ID. So ID is equal to K VGS minus VT. We don't know ID, we know K, the value of K, and we know So by substituting this one, you will get this one quadratic type of equation, and we can find out the value of ID is equal to 9.3 milliamps. The value of ID is equal to 9.3 milliamps. The value of ID is equal to 9.3 milliamps. You will get. After that, we will apply Kirchhoff voltage law for output loop. What is the Kirchhoff voltage law for output loop here? You can see here, this is the output loop. So VDD minus IDRD minus VDS. So that is the output loop. So you have to write Kirchhoff voltage law for the output loop. Then we don't know VDS. We know VDD 15 minus ID we just found out 9.3, and RD we know. Substituting that one, we will get 5.7 volt. So now with this, we will try to find out operating point. ID we got and VDS we got. So this is the one more way to find out the operating point. In the last class, previously we saw how to find out Q point using a load line method. Here, this is the other way of finding. So here we have to find first, first we have to use this equation, ID is equal to K VGS minus VT, and we have to find out K. After that, we have to apply Kirchhoff law for the input loop. When you apply the Kirchhoff law for input loop, you will get this. You will get this method. This one equation VGS is equal to minus ID. This one, and you substitute this one in this equation. You will get the equation, quadratic type equation. When you solve the quadratic type equation, you will get the value of ID, that is 9.3 milliamps. After that, you have to apply VDS is equal to VDD minus IDRD. That is the Kirchhoff voltage law for output circuit. And by applying, we will get a VDS. So now our point is our Q point. Our Q point contains two things. One is voltage. Voltage is here we got 5.7 volt and comma current is 9.3 milliamps. So this is the Q point. So in the next session or in the coming session, you will study voltage divider biasing configuration. So it's for a depletion MOSFET we saw voltage divider biasing configuration. So you will see now for the enhancement MOSFET how this one biasing is decided by using voltage divider biasing configuration. In design methodology, biasing voltage is decided by deciding R1, RD, R2 and RS.